Lord, church. Praise the Lord, church. I had to say that loud because I know a lot of y'all looking at me because y'all know my track record. But it ain't like that today. See, I can say praise the Lord. I can make you say praise the Lord. Because the God I'm serving today, he's not dead, he's alive. I thank God for God today. I thank you for being God and God all. Why? Something else. Good God to me. Now, I got a story that came to my mind. And it really hit me to my heart because it's part of why I wind up in some of the situations that I wind up in. And if I could help somebody today, some young man or young woman not to go through the pain and the degradation and the heartache and the near-death experiences that I went through, then that's what I want to do. See, because there was a story in the book of 1 Kings chapter 19 about a man named Elijah. And Elijah had an army, but he was going to fight it up against another king. I think his name was Ahab or something like that. And all of a sudden, something happened. They killed all of Elijah's army. And Elijah began to run. But one thing that happened about it, when Elijah was running, see, by Elijah being a man of God, God saw him running. God said, Elijah, why are you running? Elijah said, well, Lord, I'm seeking you zealously. They killed all my army, Ahab and them killed it, and I'm the only one that's left. So God called Ahab, he said, I want you to go up on a mountain, and I want you to stay there. And while he was up on this mountain, I need y'all to hear this, something happened on that mountain, but I presume he was waiting on the Lord. But while he was waiting, a big storm came and rented the rocks up the mountain, but God wasn't in that storm. Ain't that right? If I got this right, I mean a big hurricane or something came and blew past the mountain and God wasn't in there. Then a hurricane came or something of that sort and God wasn't in that.
That's right.
But all of a sudden a still small voice came and Elijah heard. He was able and available at that time to hear the word of God. See, I wasn't able and available to hear the word of God. See, what that cost me was two heart attacks and two strokes. Paralyzed on my right side.
Come on, man.
Crack cocaine addiction. See, I can still remember laying on the 13th floor in University Hospital. That's the floor the helicopter come in on. That's the near-death experience.
Come on, man.
But I remember waking up and somebody saying, Mr. Thomas, we need to call your next kin. All because I wasn't available. She said, because if you fall back asleep, you're going to go into another diabetic coma. Your pain's going to stop making insulin for your body. And we don't know whether you're going to wake up anymore. That's all because I wasn't available when God was calling me.
All right,
so
now.
I remember recovering from a stroke on my mother's couch. And Brother Sam, you remember, I had just came home and I was still suffering because my right side I couldn't use and I couldn't write and my nervous system was shut down. Brother Sam, if you can remember, he came in my house and picked me up off the couch and helped me set me on a chair. And he had to take one hand because my nervous system wouldn't work to hold my hand, but he is still, and one hand to cut my hand. And that's because I wasn't available to hear the word of God. David said, be still and know that I am Lord. I suffered from a crack cocaine addiction. Couldn't seem to find my way out. Bound by the ways of the devil. Sitting on somebody's psychiatric ward, wanting to kill myself because I didn't know whether I wanted to live or die. Pain and degradation. Now I got to suffer for the rest of my life. Take 12 pills a day because I got heart trouble. High blood pressure. Pancreas don't want to act right. A hole in my liver. Don't forget they tried to cripple me because I don't even have my own knees. I got titanium plastic in both of them. All because I wasn't available to hear the word of God. All because I didn't want to be still and know that he was alone. All because I didn't want to stand on the mountain and pray. Glory to God. I'm here. I've already been through the belly of the whale. Sister Cheryl, I'm no longer down in the valley of the dry bones. I thank God today that I'm standing amongst the land of the living. See, I can hear rattling sound in my bones today. I'm standing amongst the land of the living, ready to praise the Lord. And I thank God today. He didn't have to do it, but he did. Somebody here today. today don't have to go through that. Somebody don't have to go through what I've been through. But I know one thing, God is here. And he's real. And he's real to me. I got to pray my spirit in me.
Good God.